Hello students, this session will discuss counter. Okay. Let's start the topic counter. So in this session we'll discuss the introduction of counters and the different type of counters. Okay. So counter is a sequential digital device. We know that what is the meaning of digital circuit and digital device. In digital circuit or digital device, the output depends on the current input value as well as the previous information or past processing information. Basically, counter is used to count the pulses. Whatever pulses is there, it will count. Like here, we suppose there have 3-bit numbers, then the 3-bit numbers, it will count first, second, third, like that. Okay. So counters count in two different ways. One is up direction, another is down direction. That means it can count off direction, that is from lower order to higher order, and it can also count in down direction, that is called higher order to lower order. Okay, so for making of n bit counter, we need to use n number of flip flops which counts from 0 to 2 to the n minus 1. Okay, we know that counter is the application of flip flops. So when we are using the counters or when we are creating a counter, we need the flip flops. Okay, and it counts 0 to 2 to the n minus 1. Here n is the number of flip flops. For this case, we have 3-bit number. We need to construct this counter by using 3 number of flip flops. So 2 to the 3 equals to 8, and 8 minus 1 equals to 7. So it will count from 0 to 7. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, or to 7. It will count. So counter of different types, there is asynchronous or recall counter, synchronous counter, and ring counter. This ring counter is nothing but it is the application of shift register. Okay, so let's have a talk on asynchronous counter. This is also known as the recall counter, or recall counter is the type of asynchronous counter. So in asynchronous counter, whatever flip-flops are connected together, each flip-flop is triggered by the output of Q or Q naught from the previous flip-flop. Okay, so see this block circuit diagram or block diagram. So this block diagram have 3 number of flip-flops are connected to each other. Okay, see this is the T flip-flop, because both J and K are connected together. So this T flip-flop produces 2 results, that is Q and Q naught. And the Q naught is connected to the clock to the next flip flop. Okay, so similar way, again the third flip flop clock is connected with the output of the second flip flop. Okay, so this way it is connected in asynchronous counter. So here the output of each flip flop is connected to the clock to the next flip flop. Okay, so this ripple counter or asynchronous counter also counts in off direction and down direction, but that depends on the input control, how we are providing with the input. Okay, if you want to count from higher order to lower order, so that counts the down direction. If we want to count the lower order to higher order, that counts the off direction. Okay, so let's see how exactly this asynchronous counter is functioning. So this diagram says that, this block diagram, this is the 3 number of flip-flops, all are T flip-flops, and the T flip-flops all having the input values, and the input value is I. Okay, so the first flip-flop is connected clock directly, and the output of Q naught of first flip-flop is connected to the clock to the next flip-flop. Okay, here the Q naught is also connected to the next flip-flop, clock input to the next flip-flop. Clear? So as we know that clock value is from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Okay. Sometimes it is 0 and sometimes 1. When there is 1, clock value is 1. If it is working, that is called positive clock cycle. If clock is 0, if the circuit is working, then it is called negative 0, a negative clock. Why I am talking this? Because in T flip-flop, it can toggle with a single clock cycle. Okay, if the single clock cycle, the T flip flop toggles from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 between Q and Q naught. Okay, if you have any doubts, then you can watch my previous video, that is JK and T flip flop. Then you can clear your doubts. Okay, so in this diagram, timing diagram, this is called leading edge. Okay. So why I'm marking this leading edge? Because at the leading edge only the flip-flop may produce the result. Okay, it will produce the result at the leading edge. So here, when the clock is high, as the input value is high, that means one. When the clock is one, then this T flip-flop toggles and it will produce the result at the Q and Q naught. Again, Q naught is connected to the clock to the next. So this next flip flop completely depends on the output of first flip flop. Okay, or this flip flop completely depends on the output of Q naught of the first one. So similarly, before the clock value is one, all flip flop is reset to zero. So I can mark here as zero. This is also zero. This is also a zero. Okay, this is the binary value 000. So when the clock triggers or clock in leading edge, then this flip flop is triggered and it will produce the result that Q0, this one, Q0 naught becomes high. Okay, it also becomes high and it will maintain for one clock cycle. Okay, it will maintain for one clock cycle, then only this flip-flop will trigger. Okay, when this flip-flop will receive the data, if the data is available at Q naught. Okay, so till that, this flip-flop and this flip-flop remain in silence mode. So this is zero and this is zero, but what about the Q naught zero? The Q naught zero value is one. Okay, so after completing of one clock cycle, this becomes zero. This will again toggle back to zero, because see, the first clock cycle, this Q0 is zero and Q0 equals to one. Okay, Q0 equals to one. Then again, one clock cycle is complete. For the next clock cycle, this will toggle. This Q becomes one and Q naught becomes zero. Okay, the Q becomes zero. Okay, now this second flip flop produces the result at the Q naught. So now this Q naught will be one. And this one is remain for one clock cycle. Again, for one clock cycle. That means in first clock cycle, Q0 toggle, and Q1 and Q2 both are remain same as the previous state. For the second clock cycle, Q0 becomes zero and Q1 toggle and it becomes one. And the third is waiting for that next clock cycle. It works with the next clock cycle. Okay. When the next clock cycle is supplied, this zero becomes toggle. This zero becomes toggle to one and this becomes toggle to zero. Okay, this becomes zero. So with the next clock cycle, this Q0 rise up, it produces one. The same time, it already produced the result at Q, that is one. And the third flip-flop is zero state. With the next clock cycle, that means after the fourth clock cycle, third clock cycle, okay, third clock cycle, sorry, this is the rising edge, it's not the rising edge. Okay, this case, this becomes toggle to zero and this becomes also zero. But when both are zero, this third flip-flop is ready to produce the result. Okay, it will produce the result and it is ready to feedback to the next connected, so it becomes one. Okay, again clock value is changing. When the clock value is changing, then it will affect it. Then this becomes one, zero becomes one, but it will wait the time. Whatever value is there, it will wait. That value is zero. Okay, this also in waiting condition, that is one. Clear? So according to that, it will happen. See, this case, as it is connected three flip flops, so this the output at the third number flip flop will trigger after the completion of the third clock cycle. See, this case in the first clock cycle, the second clock cycle, in the third clock cycle only, this output or this value is changing to one after third clock cycle. Okay, because it will wait for the third clock cycle or third time. Okay, but every time this first is changing, every clock cycle the first flip flop is changing, and the second flip flop depends on the output of the first flip flop. That means every two clock cycle, the second flip flop is working. Every the completion of the third clock cycle, the third flip flop is working. So that means it is a little bit slow down, because it completely depends on the clock value. It is not synchronously connected to the clock value to all flip flops. Rather, it is connected to the clock value to the first one, and the output is just connected to the clock to the next flip flop. And due to this, this asynchronous flip flop is quite slower. Okay, let's have discussed about the synchronous counter. It is another type of counter. In synchronous counter, the clock value is connected to all flip-flops simultaneously. Okay, so for this reason, it is different than the asynchronous counter. Okay, so as per this block diagram, it have four number of flip-flops, and all flip-flops are connected to the clock. This is the clock symbol. This clock is connected. This first flip-flop. The clock is connected here, the clock is connected here, the clock is connected here. That means the second flip flop is not dependent on the output process of the first flip flop for the clock symbol, okay, which is happening in the asynchronous counter. Okay, so there is a NAND gate is connected here. The NAND gate is connected to the input to the third number flip flop. Similarly, another NAND gate is used as an input to the fourth number of flip flops. This NAND gate receives the output from first flip flop and second flip flop, combinedly produce the result, and it will input to the third number of flip flop. Okay. So as per this timing diagram, seen again, so VCC is the power supply or value supply. That is the input value. When you supply the input to this flip-flop, so again the flip-flop having the chance to toggle it, because it is a toggle flip-flop, because J and K both are connected together, so it is a toggle flip-flop. When you supply one here and the clock is high, then this flip-flop will toggle. Then if it is toggle, then what is the result here? The same time it will produce zero, because there is no input to this J and K terminal. Similarly, there is no input at the J and K terminal. Here also, we are not giving any input to the J and K terminal. Just we supply the clock to all flip-flops. That means all flip-flops are ready to receive the data and ready to process the data. Okay, but at the output side of Q becomes zero. The value is nothing. That means zero. So zero is supplied here. A toggle and one is supply here, and we know that for AND gate 1.0 equals to zero. Let me describe it. So in the first clock cycle, this value is one, say it is a toggle, and this value is zero. So in the NAND gate, we know that 1.0 equals to zero. Okay, that means this also, the input to this gate is zero. That means this is not ready to receive the data. So here also it becomes zero, and this zero, 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 not means zero, it is not ready to receive the data. That means for the first clock cycle, the remaining three flip-flops are producing the zero except the first one. Okay, the same situation is happening here at the falling edge. It works with the falling edge of the clock. We can use the leading edge of the clock also. If you are using the leading edge of the clock pulse, then we have to thinking about the Q naught. Okay, so this is the falling edge. Just I'm marking it the falling edge of the clock. Okay, so see, when the clock is down, then Q becomes high, or Q produce the result one with the one clock cycle. This is the one clock cycle. Okay, what about the remaining? That means one is available here, but the remaining are zero. Okay, the Q is zero, so the remaining value is zero. Okay, with the next falling edge, the Q becomes down. That means see, okay, so for this falling edge, as it is a toggle flip flop, this Q first produce one here, and after this clock pulse or after the one clock cycle, this becomes zero. Whatever the value of here, input value, you don't care about that. Just one supply here, the input is one, that means input is high. So this one becomes zero. So there is another connection. This one is supplied to the second flip flop also. So when one is here, then it can produce G, it can produce one. Okay, the Q becomes one. Q becomes one for the second flip flop. That means for this one, Q is one. But what about the output of zero? This zero, Q equals to zero. For this case, it is zero. Again, this becomes zero, becomes one, and one becomes zero. Again, it will produce zero. So it becomes zero, and this also produces zero. So if we make another time gram, that is Q of D or Q of 3, then it is also zero for this case, right? And for the next, it will maintain for the next clock cycle. That means when the clock is back, then again Q toggle, Q1 toggle. So one is available here, okay, Q1 toggle, that toggle value becomes one, so it will maintain one here, and it is one with the same clock cycle only, it will also zero. That means they are waiting for the signal from this NAND gate when the clock is complete. Okay, then again the clock down, okay, it will down back. The same time, this also down back because the clock is here also creating the effect. So this NAND gate produce first is one, first value is one. Okay, this zero becomes one because it was toggle. Okay, 1.1, one is already available here. This zero becomes one again. So 1.1, it produce one. So that means now this flip-flop is ready to toggle. Okay, one is available here, then this flip-flop is ready to toggle. So here the output is one here. Okay, this becomes one and this is one, but still this value is zero. Okay, and for the next clock cycle, this is zero and this is also zero and this becomes one. And this for the next clock cycle, this becomes one, and this is zero, and this is one. See, if we think about the binary value of these numbers, this zero, zero, and zero. So zero, zero, zero. That means zero, 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 one is one, zero, one, zero. So I'm writing here zero, zero. and 0. So here also 0. So for the first clock cycle, the every value is 0. Okay, means I mean 0th clock cycle, or it is ready to functioning, start to functioning. For the second thing, this is 0, 0, 0 and 1. With the first clock cycle, this becomes 1. Okay, for the second clock cycle, this value becomes 2. 0, 0, 0, 1, 2. So here, this is the Q of A. This denote Q of A. Say I'm taking this is the B, Q of B, Q of C, and Q of D. Okay, so according to that, it will count up to 1, 1, 1, and 1. Okay, that sequence is 15. In decimal, it is called 15. So for that, to count from 0 to 15, we need at least 4 number of flip-flops. Okay, so see, this last flip-flop will toggle after the 4th number of clock cycle. Okay, because this first flip-flop will trigger the first clock cycle, this trigger the second clock cycle, this trigger the third clock cycle, this trigger the fourth clock cycle. That means till fourth clock cycle, this flip-flop becomes 0. When the completion of the fourth clock cycle or end of the fourth clock cycle, this becomes toggle to 1. Okay, so in this case it is quite faster than the asynchronous counter, because in asynchronous counter the clock value completely depends on the working of the first flip-flop or the previous flip-flop. But this case is all flip-flops simultaneously supplied the clock value to all flip-flops, right? So this is the synchronous counter. Okay, next one is the ring counter, and we know that ring counter is the application of register, the shift register. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram, sorry, block diagram. In the last class I already said, if the Q is feedback to the input value, that is called ring counter. If Q not is feedback to the input value, that is called twister ring counter. That is also called the Johnson counter. Okay, so very simple. So let's quick review of this circuit, of this topic. Okay, in the first classes we said that what is circuit, that is two types. One is the combinational circuit and sequential circuit. In combinational circuit, the output completely depends on the in current input values, but in case of sequential circuit, the output depends on the current input value as well as the past input information or part processing information. The type of combinational circuits are MOX, decoder, adder, demux, encoder, etc. In case of sequential circuit, we have flip-flops, registers and counters. Okay, we have already covered flip-flops, registers and counters. Flip-flops are of four types: SR flip-flop, JK flip-flop, T flip-flop and D flip-flop. In SR flip-flop is the root of all flip-flops. That means when a JK flip-flop is developed, that is the use of SR flip-flop only, or just making some modification in case of SR flip-flop. Whatever the flip-flop is generated, that is called JK flip-flop, D flip-flop, and the modification inside the JK flip-flop develop a T flip-flops. Okay, so there is also the master slave JK flip-flop also there, and S trigger flip-flop. Any kind of flip-flop can be considered as S trigger flip-flop. Okay, because if it is working with a positive edge, or it works in the negative edge. Then the application of flip-flops are, one is register, another is counter. There are so many applications are there. These two are popular applications. A register is nothing but it is a group of flip-flops, and this register is used to store the data and transfer the data. Okay, it is also having different types, like left shift register, right shift register. The mode of shifting register are parallel shifting and serial shifting. And the counter is used to count the pulses. Okay, it is also used flip flops. If there is n number of n bit counters, then it needs n flip flops. Okay, but the counters have two types, basic two types. One is asynchronous or ripple counter, another is synchronous counter. Another type of counters are there, like ring counter, twisted ring counter, up down counter, Mobius counter, like that. But these two are the standard one. Okay, so in asynchronous counter, the first clock, the second flip flop's clock value depends on the output of the first one. Okay, in case of synchronous, that thing is not happening. In the clock is simultaneously supplied to all connected flip flops. Okay, this is all about your flip flops topic, flip flops and registers and counters. Okay, so if you have any doubt, then you just ping me. Okay, so in the next class we'll discuss about the multiplexer. Multiplexer is one kind of combinational circuit. We'll discuss multiplexer, demultiplexer, okay, encoder, decoder in the next few classes. Okay, and from coming classes onwards we'll discuss only the combinational circuits. Okay, so let me try to clarify that before starting this combinational circuit topic. I'm planning to do a online exam regarding the sequential circuit. Okay, so I will inform you. So thank you so much.